sage professor turned fighter adventurer for a most intriguing motive. Einar was born in the city of Eraska, in the Forgotten Realm, to parents Freya and Othorian, conservative socialites of the upper class. His birth was merely a matter of course for a budding socialite couple who would comply with any social norm laid in their path. Parents by happenstance, they lacked the warmth and drive to excel at nurturing life. While they still care for Einar, their lack of involvement throughout his life has left an unreasonable desire for Einar to garner their love and respect with little success. Over the years, they have further distanced themselves from his path as to not disrupt their status quo lifestyle and avoid being outcasts by proxy. Einar led a scripted upper-class elven life. He was an acclaimed researcher and historian of the multiverse. He spent years learning its lore. He scoured manuscripts, studied scrolls, and listened to the greatest experts on the subjects that interested him most. His efforts have made him a master in his fields of study. He participated as expected in the haughty upper-class social scene, but never felt comfortable in those roles. The common traditional elven love of nature, magic, art, music, and poetry fell by the wayside as his narrowing and focused life mission consumed him. His unwavering need for logic, reason, the scientific method, and its values caused strife in his religious upbringing, and his faith to Selyun, goddess of the moon, increasingly wavered. As he pushed his research and learning past the standards of traditional education, years of digging and questioning the establishment began to reveal discrepancies in the history and the lore of the worlds. He developed an insatiable drive to find out the truths of the world against the guise the establishment has maintained for millennia. Research in academia only answered so much and left him with more questions than answers. The public profile of his work left him bare to opponents of his venture. More frequently, he met with increasing resistance and subversive threats of sabotage and violence against him and his work. The more he questioned, the more resistance he met. This began to slowly erode his reputation. While striving for solitude and privacy in his life, he furthered his adolescent weapons training at the prestigious Academy of Arms. While attempting to maintain stealth in his preparations, he spent much time training himself in the way of the wielded weapon, becoming a scarless battlemaster. We find Einar reaches turning point when one day he anonymously receives an unidentifiable and untraceable ancient text that coincides with nothing he's previously known. Recognizing the gravity and importance of this artifact, he has no choice but to answer the myriad questions associated with it and his inheritance of it. Suddenly, his years of battle training seem relevant to providing the artifact the protection it deserves from him as its handler, and forcing the world's truths through might. The only means he has left to quench his desire for knowledge and solve the puzzle of the ancient text is an epic quest to uncover the darkest truths of the multiverse. In doing so, he leaves behind any hopes of regaining the support and respect of his parents and the accolades of a highly respected career. After spending half his life established and tied to the same city, community, social class, and lifestyle, venturing into the unknown is akin to abandoning all he knows. Never having an equal in class, work, intelligence, or friendship, Einar has no one to depend on now. He eternally emblazons a symbol above his heart, a phoenix rising through a ring of fire. Nothing but his deepest desires now drive him into that darkest unknown to somehow fulfill his relentless need to answer the questions that generations have hidden and forgotten all about. Will Einar succeed? Will he release the multiverse from the ageless bonds of mistruth? Only time will tell.